Hello, this is Christy. Here's a quick video in Descript to show you how you can annotate portions of screen recordings. Maybe you want to show a red border around them or a circle. You can do this in Descript. So this is very easy. I have a tutorial here where I show some things in Descript, but I would like to maybe highlight this portion here where I show this dropdown where I'm inviting someone to a project. So how do I do this? In Descript, there are no annotation tools like you would find in Camtasia or other tools that do screen recording and instructional videos, but you can still use some elements to create those. So I'm using shapes. For example, if I want to show this with a border around it, like a red border around this area, I go to shapes. But before I do that, I would like to make a selection, because in Descript, if you add something and you have no scenes, it adds that element to the entire timeline. I don't want to do that. So the idea is that I'm going to click in here and say, you know what? I want to show that for just this paragraph, right? So I make a selection in text first, and you notice on the timeline at the bottom, the same selection that I made in the text is highlighted in blue on the timeline. So now, whatever I add to my composition will be added and restricted to this particular selection that I made. So I'm going to go to the top where it's got the shapes and open that, and I'm going to use a rectangle. Click on that, and you see it has added that rectangle down on the timeline, and it's limited it to that particular section that I selected. And in fact, it created a scene. Scene number 2 is the one that contains this rectangle, right? So that's important. But now the rectangle obviously doesn't look like what I want it to look. So I'm going to click on it and change it. First of all, I want to change the border, right? So if you click on it and go to the right-hand side, it says border. Click the plus icon to turn on the border. And there it is. It's quite thin. So I'm going to click on this number and say, let's say a 12 pixel thick border. It is black, of course. So I'm going to click on this little circle next to it to change the color. Click on this, and I'm going to make it red. Okay. And I think it's actually still too thin. Let's make it 18. Yeah, quite thick. So now the last step is to go and remove the fill. You see the fill icon here? I can click on this to change transparency of the fill like this, or I can just click the minus sign and it gets rid of the fill completely. And there is a change here because the fill was covering half the border. So if you feel like the border is now too thick, you can go back and change it to about 14. There you go. And finally, let's grab this rectangle and place it around the object we want to highlight, like this. There you go. You can resize it, and there's your border. And now if I want this border to show up with a fade in and fade out, it's very easy. You can either add a fade transition to it. If you go on the timeline and make the timeline tall enough, you will notice that when you hover over the layer, and by the way, I'm using the new Descript timeline, which is going to come soon. You can turn it on in the labs, but it's similar on the existing one. At the end of every clip, there's a little dot, a little white dot. If you grab that and just pull it, you're creating a fade in transition. You see there, there's like a line, and it's going to fade in. And let's do the end, fade out, grab the end one and pull it back. So now look, if I'm playing, you can see this one fading in and out as we work on. And we've been doing this for years. And I do hope that these could... And let's see the fade out. Open, and they will be able to open that project. Again, they need to be logged in. There you go. So that is how you create annotations on the screen in Descript using these shapes. And let me show you another one. You can do circles also. If I want to grab a circle, let me select another portion, maybe down the line here. And I'm going to make a selection again, like there. And go to the shapes. Use an ellipse this time. There you go. And again, remove the fill, turn on the border, make it red, and make it very thick. 16. Okay. And again, you can resize it. By the way, if you're resizing it and it gets deformed, hold down the shift key. And when you resize it, it stays a circle no matter what you do. And then I can move it around here and highlight my face for some reason. So there you go. And also you have arrows, by the way. Here you go. You have arrows. You can grab an arrow and point it to some place. Again, you need to, you know, this is the end of the arrow. I'm going to show this one here and change the arrow to red. Make it thicker. You don't need to change the fill because an arrow doesn't have a fill. And there you go, you have an arrow right there. And you can point it in any direction you want, like this. So again, Descript doesn't have annotation tools as you would understand them in other programs, but you can still use these basic shapes to show some things on the screen. So I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching. If you enjoy these videos, feel free to like them, subscribe to my channel. And also, if you would like to join my Media Makers Club, which is a community where you can have access to my Descript courses, one-on-one coaching with me, Q&A sessions, and many other things, check the link in the description for that. Thank you again, and see you next time.